I surmise na baka itong dineliver ninyong mga computer are not in good condition anymore. Ibig sabihin, inulit nyo from publication, from step one. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am. And I'm very sorry kung hindi ko po nabanggit.
Why did you not bother to volunteer this information? Is this another attempt to suppress information?
At nakakagulat, Madam Chair, if we move forward, nakita ngayon dito sa inyong report, because this is the DepEd computerization program. At ang nakakalungkot, ang pinag-uusapan dito is not even 2024. This is discussing 2022 CONAP, which translates to about 9.185 billion, and 2023 budget, which is around 11.4 billion.
Another member will ask question is Congresswoman Jinky Luistro.
I wish to direct this question to the Program Implementation Director, please. Kanina po, I repeatedly ask you, who causes the delay? What causes the delay? You keep on saying you prioritize 2022. I wish to ask now, with all the revelations of the Honorable Bonggalyon, why did you not bother to volunteer these informations? You see, 16 lots were bidded, only 2 were awarded, the 14 were rebidded. Second, the variance from 24% to 1%. And then the change in officials. These are all material. In the reason for the delay that I asked from you this morning. Why did you not bother to volunteer this information? Is this another attempt to suppress information?
Thank you very much, Your Honor. Ma'am, kanina po nung sumagot ako sa inyo kung bakit na-delay, sinabi ko po yung change of leadership. Binanggit ko po yon. Yung pong pag-strategize.
Yes, the change of leadership is a common knowledge from the previous to the current secretary. However, these are material facts which you should have volunteered. When I repeatedly ask you, what causes the delay? Who causes the delay? This is not simple changes that went through in the Department of Education. Nag-ulit kayo ng bidding? Ibig sabihin, inulit nyo from publication, from step one. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am. And I'm very sorry kung hindi ko po nabanggit yung ang diniscuss ko po kanina ay yung change of leadership and the reconfiguration of the DCP project. Na ngayon, ma'am, doon sa procurement, tama po yung sinasabi ni Congressman na nag-bidding, tapos meron lang pong nanalo ng mga lots, tapos po nag-rebid. Kaya din po, binanggit ko din po yung kanina na kailangan
namin
mag...
If I may interrupt, I wish to manifest my concurrence to the observation of my esteemed colleagues, the Honorable Bonggalyon, the Honorable Garin, the Honorable Asidre, and even the Honorable Amatong. And I therefore respectfully invoke, Madam Chair, the oversight power of the Congress. Thus, this representation respectfully move for the issuance of subpoena duces tecum in order to require the office concerned to produce all the bidding documents 2022, 2023, 2024, including the acceptance of the end users. And I wish to know also the feedback of the teachers, because I surmise na baka itong dineliver ninyong mga computer are not in good condition anymore. I wish to manifest as well, Madam Chair, that if we are able to establish findings based on the documents to be submitted to us, then I recommend that we initiate a separate investigation on this. So move, Madam Chair.
We hear a motion duly seconded from the members of this committee to issue a subpoena for all the documents. And by virtue of the oversight function of the committee, there any objection? Hearing none, the motion is carried.
Madam Chair, I just wish to manifest that the recommendation to conduct a separate investigation is in order not to compromise the budget process of the Department of Education under the new secretary, with whom I wish to express hope that we will be able to find ways in able to address, to be able to address the delays and the irregularities which we have established through this budget briefing, Madam Chair. Thank you.
Thank you to Congresswoman Luistro. We will cooperate in furnishing documents. We pledge that, Your Honor, Madam Chair.
Thank you very much, Representative Luistro. Deputy Majority Leader Janet Garin.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. A pleasant good afternoon to our DepEd family. Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, marami sana akong katanungan, but I was surprised but by what I was hearing from Congressman Jill Bongolan. Madam Chair, nalito lang ako doon, no, because there was mention about this DepEd computerization program. Is this the topic that the Honorable Congressman was talking about earlier? Is this a DepEd computerization program? Yes. So I've known Yusek Law. Is this Yusek Law Jumalin? Humalin?
Jumamil is her middle name. Opa.
Jumamil Mercado. Opa. Yes. Okay.
Jumamil,
okay.
Mercado.
And she joined DepEd recently because I knew she was from
DAP. From DAP. Ho.
From DAP. Opa. Okay. So it makes me wonder, Madam Chair, Your Honors, why an official, a public servant who has been wanting to serve government will retire from DepEd. So baka mamaya, Honorable Secretary, Madam Chair, naging masalimuot yung procurement process, so much so that reputable public officials will have to resign from office. If I may, balikan ko lang po Yusek Chan. Sa first procurement, the hope is Yusek Glo Mercado. And the back chair is Asek Bringas. Tama po ba?
Yung sa hope, I'm still checking, Your Honor, kasi ngayon ko lang siya nire-retrieve pa namin. But if it's not Yusek Law, then it will be Yusek Poa, either of the two.
Can you check,
yes,
with your staff?
Yes.
Okay. And in the second procurement, the hope was Yusek Michael Poa.
Yes.
Okay. Ang pangalawa kong tanong, you also mentioned, may sinabi kasi si Congressman Jill na variance. Can you laymanize what variance means? Say, Yusek for procurement.
Yung sinasabi po ni Congressman is parang nung unang bid, ganito yung...
Can you laymanize it? Pwede ba nating sabihin, diferensya sa presyo?
Diferensya sa presyo.
So, ibig sabihin, yung unang bidding, mas mura ng 24%. Tama o mali?
I will check on that kasi ngayon pa lang.
Yung check naman, yung previous hearings lang kasi natin sa oversight ng APRO, you always tell us you will check. Can we request your staff to... Yeah, can you
yes,
check?
Honor.
Yes, yes. And I hope, Madam Chair, that will not be taken from my time.
We will check, Your Honor, because this issue was just raised
okay.
Now. In the
so
oversight,
when we talk
else.
About 24%, I heard the figure 1.6 billion. Tama po ba?
Yun po yung nabanggit.
Okay. When we talk about 1% variance, magkano po siya?
I'm not sure what Congressman, the good congressman was referring to.
I mean,
to
you can extract it from the data that was given. 24% equates to 1.6 billion. Now, 1% variance would equate to how much? Tama po ba na nasa mga 60 plus million? approximately?
I will have to check, Your Honor, kasi there are, as mentioned by Congressman Bonggalon, there are 16 lots. So we will have to track. There are 16 lots during that bidding. We will have to track kung saan yung variants doon during the first round,
yes,
and the second round.
Madam Chair, the reason why this caught our attention, kasi ang sabi ni Yusek Chan, nagbidding pero may mga kulang na papel. Kaya binid ulit, pero nung binid ulit, nagkaroon na ng compliance. Kasi natural naman, nakakalimutan or nagkakamali minsan yung ibang mga suppliers. Pero Madam Chair, Honorable Secretary, napakamahal naman ng dementia na ito. Nakalimutan lang yung ibang papel, nung nakumpleto na yung papel, nawalan ang gobyerno ng 1.54 billion. That's a very expensive cost of lapse in documentation and lapse in memory. At nakakagulat, Madam Chair, if we move forward, nakita ngayon dito sa inyong report, because this is the DepEd computerization program. At ang nakakalungkot, ang pinag-uusapan dito is not even 2024. This is discussing 2022 CONAP, which translates to about 9.185 billion, and 2023 budget, which is around 11.4 billion. Magkano nga po ba ang 2024? Okay. Madam Chair, 2024 po, DCP, DepEd Computerization Program.
11.3. Madam Chair, to answer the question a while ago, during the original bid and the rebid, ang hope po ay si Yusek Michael Powana po.
So pareho yung hope. Okay. But then yung 2024.
Yung ano po?
2024 DCP, DepEd Computerization Program.
It's 8.7 million, Your Honor.
Okay, 8.7
billion.
Billion. Okay. So, Madam Chair, mas lalong nakakapagtaka, pareho ang hope, pareho ang back, nagkaroon ng bid failure kasi kulang yung dokumento ng ibang suppliers, nag-submit sila ng dokumento, ganun ba kamahal ang pamasahe para pumunta sa DepEd Procurement Office, kaya magsasayang tayo ng 1.6 billion? Pangalawa, Madam Chair, bakit po naging ganito? 2022, 9.185 billion yung CONAP, and if you combine 2022 and 2023, it comes out that the obligation is only 50%. Wala pa dyan ang 2024. Understandably, ang expenditure ng 2024 will be zero. Kasi wala pa nga sa kalahati noong 2022 and 2023. Ibig sabihin, hindi minamadali. Madam Chair, Your Honors, I would respect the procurement process. Pero sa probinsya, sa mga paaralan, wala ngang computers, walang kagamitan. Bakit ganito kabagal ang proseso? Was there a failure of leadership? Was there a failure of miscommunication? Was there an attitude of not wanting to deliver services to our people? Because, Madam Chair, sa totoo lang, we are happy that Senator Sani, Secretary Sani Angara is there, who understands the predicament of what the people needs. Kasi dapat ni puso rin ang pagseservisyo. So let me go back. Una, kung pareho lang ang hope, pareho lang ang back chair, nag-bid failure, inulit, naging mahal, at pinakwalify. What transpired in between? It is something, Madam Chair, Your Honors, that makes us think sadyang pinabagal, sadyang hindi ginamit, pero nung ginamit na mahal at ang daming pasikot-sikot na nangyari, which actually result to zero actual implementation based on the report of the Commission and Audit. Because it says ICT packages physical accomplishment. Ibig sabihin, nakita, naramdaman, nagamit ng taong bayan. And the result for 2022
is zero. 2023, zero. Madam Chair, Your Honors, pagka gusto nating hindi magka-Alzheimer's at dementia, kumakain tayo ng dalawang itlog araw-araw. Pero itong dalawang itlog ng DepEd, and this is not during the time of Secretary Angara, dalawang itlog na pwedeng maging itlog ang grades ng ating kabataan. And Your Honors, I'm really sorry, but this is something that should not be laughed at and taken for granted. We keep on complaining about poor quality of education. We keep on complaining about budget. Pero andun yung budget eh. Andun yung bidding eh. Nag-bid failure, naging mahal, nawala yung mga tao. Nagkapalitan, nagka-resign. And ngayon, we are now faced with a zero physical target and physical accomplishment. May we get the wisdom of Yusek Chan on this?
Yes, Your Honor. I will be asking the program end user, kasi sila po, when you say zero implementation, I think you're referring to the delivery, the actual implementation on the ground, and they are in the, as the,
yes, it says a while ago. Physical accomplishment, quantity for 2022, zero, quantity for 2023, zero, natural percentage, zero. Napakasakit po, Madam Chair, Secretary Sunny. Gusto ko po yung itlog bawat umaga pangontra sa Alzheimer's. Pero kung itlog para sa mga estudyante ay hindi po katanggap-tanggap, Mr. Chair, Madam Chair.
Sir, pwede na. Okay na. Okay. Good afternoon, Madam Chair, Your Honor. Doon po sa DCP from 2022, 2023, and 2024 fund years, hindi po tayo zero. In fact, sa 2022 po, meron po tayong 4,067 packages, 91.47% nito na deliver na. At yung STV natin na pabra sa public schools, na 337 packages, 309 nito o 91.69% na deliver na po. At yung laptop for teaching and laptop for non-teaching, 100% po na-deliver na just for the fund year 2022.
Tapos, ma'am. Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, yeah, I'm really sorry, no. Maganda pong pakinggan, sir, yung iyong explanation. But documents from the Commission on Audit says, out of the 16 lots awarded and are scheduled to be delivered by April 2024, while the remaining 13 lots are scheduled to be delivered May 2024. And this is referring to 2022 procurement. Ang ibig niyo pong sabihin, na-deliver na recently dahil nagkaroon ng oversight hearing ang Committee on Appropriations.
Ma'am, hindi ko po masagot kung dahil yun sa Oversight Committee, pero hindi po tumigil yung ICTS na may-ari ng program into fine-tuning kung ano man po yung DepEd computerization program.
But for the record, Madam Chair, it's a 2022 budget.
Yes.
Initial delivery happened in April and May 2024. Mas mabilis pa po ang pagong mag-deliver, Madam Chair. I'm not referring to you actually, sir, but I'm referring to the whole system and the possible lapses in leadership. And we're putting this up on the table simply because we believe that Secretary Sunny Angara and the DepEd family can solve these problems para hindi na po maulit.
Yes, thank you po for that note. Ma'am, yun pong ating DCP 2022, ang contract po niyan is December 28, kasi nagtumawid po siya ng 2023, naging continuing po siya at na-deliver na po siya as of June 26, 2024.
Kaya ang tanong, Madam Chair, bakit po tumawid? Bakit matagal? Bakit palaging bid failure? Bakit nagmahal?
Ma'am, yung I was onboarded by DepEd January 2023 as ICTS Director. Nung dumating po kami, hindi pa po nagagalaw yung fund ng 2022 kasi ka-onboard lang po ng team ni VP ng July. So we have to recalibrate yung DepEd computerization program. Magbibigay ba ng computer laboratory o e-learning classroom na lang? Tapos noon pong nabigyan kami ng go signal to recast it as e-learning, so we have to conduct the market survey again.
Sir, with due courtesy,
Opo.
Maganda naman pong sabihin, nire-recalibrate at pinag-iisipan nyo. But these are programs embedded in the 2022 budget and the 2023 budget. That is not the time to plan what programs will be implemented by DepEd. Ang ibig sabihin nun, ando doon na napondohan na ibig sabihin, hiningi nyo at kailangan ng mga schools. Because I believe IT is the way to move forward. So my question is, bakit nagkaroon pa ng intensyon ng palitan yung nasa budget na? That's technical malversation, Madam Chair, right? Hindi na natin pwedeng baguhin yung pondo na ando doon na. So dahil sa desire to change the budget and the program, we are in this mess na nasa 2024 na tayo at magta-2025 na tayo, nagri-ring na yung bell, Madam Chair, pero hindi ko pa rin makakalimutan na kung tinitingnan ko ang DepEd computerization program ay panay itlog ang ating naha-harvest.
Ma'am, if I may be allowed to answer.
Yes, quickly, please.
Yeah, quickly. Ma'am, yung 2022 nga po, ang sabi namin, we have to recalibrate, refocus, reconfigure because of what happened in the DCP in 2020 and 2021. The guidelines was in 2010, so we have to revise it to reflect the needs of the time in 2023. Tapos, ma'am, to answer your question, yung 2023 fund year at 2024 fund year, nabili na rin po natin yung in-mark for DCP. In fact, for 2023, we have 96% obligation rate, and for 2024, we have 86% obligation rate already. So, nung earlier po ng later part ng 2023, naubos na doon natin po yung continuing 2022, at pagpasok po ng 2024, ay isinalang po yung continuing 2023 and the current fund year 2024. Kasi we subscribe to the observation of your honor na talagang kailangan yung technology sa loob ng classrooms natin. Ngayon, ma'am, ang lahat ng ito ay procured and ready for delivery. In fact, may mga nade-delivers na po tayo.
Madam Chair, last comment lang po, kung pwede lang. Well,
yes,
I do respect the time. Very last comment, Madam Chair. My records contradicts the input of our good official here. No, sorry lang talaga, sir, no? Yung delivery obligation na 96%, disbursement na 98%. But all of this can be answered if we have the proper documents. Madam Chair, I don't have the luxury of time, but may I request the committee that the DepEd furnish this August body a copy of all the bid documents for bid number 1 and the failed biddings, bid number 2, including the cost of each, the items procured, who are these contractors, na kulang-kulang yung papel, pero yung naging kumpleto na yung papel ay naging mahal, and of course, the processes that transpired 2022, 2023, and early part of 2024, so that this mess in the DepEd computerization program will not be repeated, Madam Chair. Kasi masarap ang itlog, pero kung yung itlog ang binibigay natin sa klase ng edukasyon, ay hindi po karapat-dapat para sa mamamayang Pilipino. Salamat, Madam Chair.